everyone, I am Assistant Professor Urmi Shah from ITICT Department of LG Institute of Engineering and Technology. So today we will be discussing about the major numerical component of this telecommunication engineering subject. Let's move ahead with the numerical section. Up till now we have covered all the theoretical sections of telecommunication engineering subject, that is unit 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. Now let's move ahead with the examples. So here the first example is from the data network chapter, that is calculate maximum data rate for noiseless channel, that is 3 kHz bandwidth and 1000 discrete signal level. Now for noiseless channel, to calculate the maximum data rate, the solution here begins from the equation of maximum data rate for noiseless channel, that is 2 into h into log v to the base 2, having the unit of data rate as bps, bits per second. So here r stands for maximum data rate, H stands for bandwidth and V stands for discrete signal level. So keeping the value or the data which is already given in question, R is equal to 2 into 3, 1000 log 1000 to the base 2. Now many students are doing the mistake over here that they are calculating directly log 1000 in calculators, but here you have to check that it is having a base 2, not base 10. So what you will do, you will convert log base 2 into log base 10. For that the formula is log 1000 you will calculate in base 10 divide by log 2 to the base 10, because we have to remove the base 2. So that's why log 1000 to the base 10 divide by log 2 to the base 10. That is the formula and the answer you will calculate is 59.8 kilobits per second. So this is maximum data rate for noiseless channel. Now the same question is asked to you that calculate the maximum data rate for noisy channel, then there will be a change in the formula, that is 2h log to the base 2 1 plus SNR ratio. In that case in question the data for SNR ratio will be provided to you. Okay, now the next question over here is consider a PSTN which receives 240 calls per hour. Each call lasts an average of 5 minutes. What is the outgoing traffic intensity to the public network? So here the formula is A is equal to mu into H, where mu is the number of calls per hour, H is the holding time for each call. So here the data is already given, 240 into 5, so your total traffic will be 1200 minutes per hour. But this traffic is for specific 1 hour time or 1 hour busy period, that is having 60 minutes. So 1200 divided by 60, answer will be 20 or long. In every numerical, the unit of answer is very important. If it is not written, that means you have half done numerical, half is left, you are not knowing what you have to find out. So the unit of traffic, unit of time period, unit of holding time, everything has to be mentioned with specific data and unit form. So here using this numerical we can conclude that 20 hours of circuit talk time is required for every hour of elapsed time, and an average of T1 voice circuits are busy at any time is 20. So this is the second numerical. Moving ahead, the third numerical is call established at 2 a.m. between a central computer and a data terminal, assuming a continuous connection and data transfer at 34 kilobit per second. What is the traffic if the call is terminated at 2:45 a.m.? So basically Call started at 2 a.m. ended at 2:45. So the total duration of call is 45 minutes. In this 45 minutes, how many calls? Only one call and occupied for 1 hour only. So the traffic is 45 divided by 60. So the traffic for these specific condition is 0.75 Erlang. There is nothing to do with how much data you are transferring. There is the only time duration and for how much time the call was held. So these are the basic requirements for traffic calculation. Otherwise, redundant information will be given to you that you have to simply let it go. So the traffic for these specific category is 0.75 Erlang. Next question is, a group of 20 subscribers generate 50 calls with an average holding time of 3 minutes. What is the average traffic per subscriber? So here total 50 calls each for 3 minutes and divide by the total time, that is 60 minutes. So it is 2.5 Erlang for one specific call. Such 20 subscribers have done the call. So 2.5 divided by 20, it will be 0.125 Erlang per subscriber. For all the subscriber, it is 2.5. That is the total traffic. 50 calls into 3 into 1 hour, that is divided by 60 minutes. So it is 2.5 Erlang total traffic. Per subscriber traffic is 2.5 divided by 20. The number of subscribers you have to consider whenever you are calculating per subscriber traffic. So this is the answer. Next, there are 100 subscribers with the following traffic profile, that is 20 make 1 call hour for 6 minutes, 20 make 3 calls per hour for half a minute, and 16 make 1 call per hour for 1 minute. So each of them you have to calculate in traffic, 20 into 1 into 6 divided by 60. So for first one it is 2 Erlang. For second one, 20 into 3 into 0.5 divided by 60, it is 0.5 Erlang. Then for the last one, 60 into 1 divided by 60, that is 1 Erlang. So the total traffic for all the 3 subscriber or 3 telephone profile is 3.5 Erlang. Total traffic you have to divide by all the number of subscriber to have per subscriber traffic, that is 3.5 divided by 100. It is 35 milli Erlang traffic per subscriber for this specific telephone network. Now the next one is, a 4 wire circuit has an overall loss of 1 decibel and balance return loss at each end is 6 decibel. We have to calculate the stability margin and the attenuation of talker and listener echo. So overall the formula over here for loss calculation is 2 into V plus L2. L2 is given to you for 4 wire circuit, it is 1 decibel loss. So LS will be calculated by keeping L2 is equal to minus V. That is V minus V, it will be 0, LS will be 0. So at singling point the loss will be 6 decibel as the value of V is 6 dB. A stability margin, it will be M is equal to V plus L2. So V is 1, V is 6 and L2 is 1, so it will be 7 dB. This way we can calculate the stability margin. The attenuation will be calculated for 2 into L2 plus V, that is 8 decibel, and then for further attenuation you can have the formulation like 2L2 plus 2V. You can go on for calculating attenuation at each stages, it will be 14 dB. The next is the same for 120 outgoing calls of average duration 2 minutes in a busy hour receives 200 incoming calls for average 3 minutes. We have to calculate outgoing traffic, incoming traffic and total traffic. So 120 into 2 divided by 60, outgoing traffic is 4 Erlang. Incoming traffic is 200 into 3 divided by 60, that is 10 Erlang. and the total traffic is summation of incoming and outgoing, that is 14 erlang. This way, traffic calculation questions will be frequently asked. During the busy hour, on average, a customer with a single telephone line makes 3 calls and receives 3 calls. The average call duration is 2 minutes. What is the probability that a caller will find the line engaged? A single telephone line makes 3 calls plus 3 calls received in time of 2 minutes. So, it will be 3 plus 3 into 2 divided by 60. So, occupancy or the traffic for this particular line is 0.2 erlang. Next is, an exchange serves 2000 subscribers. If average BHCA, that is busy hour call attempt, is 10,000 and CCR, that is call completion rate, is 60%, calculate busy hour calling rate. So, total average busy hour call we will calculate first using BHCA and CCR, that is 10,000 into 60 divided by 100. So, it will be 6,000 average calls. Now, these average calls we will divide by the total number of subscribers to have busy hour calling rate. So, it will be 3. This is a rate, so it is not having any unit. Next, in a group of 10 servers, each is occupied for 30 minutes in an observation interval of 2 hours, calculate the traffic carried by the group. So, it is having 10 servers. Per server or per source, it will be 30 by 120, so 0.25 erlang, and such 10 servers are there, so multiply by 10, it will be total 2.5 erlang. Moving ahead, a group of 20 server carry a traffic of 10 erlang. If the average duration of a call is 3 minutes, calculate the number of calls put through by a single server and the group as a whole is 1 hour period. So, total servers are 20. Traffic carried is 10 erlang, that is the total traffic. So, per server it is 10 by 20, 0.5 erlang. Number of calls through by one server will be 30 divided by 3, so 10 calls, and such 20 servers will have the calls. So 20 into 10, 200 calls are the total calls done by whole server group. Next is a subscriber 3-phase call of 3 minutes, 4 minutes and 2 minutes done in an hour period. Calculate the total traffic in erlang, CCS and CM. So, in erlang, it is very easy to calculate 3 plus 4 plus 2 divided by 60, 0.15 erlang. Now, in CCS, whatever the erlang value is there, you will multiply by 36 to have CCS, that is centum call second. It is 5.4 CCS. Call minutes is 0.15 into 60, as in 1 minute there are 60 seconds, or in 1 hour there are 60 minutes. So, if I am converting to erlang to CM, I will multiply it by 60. So, it is 9 call minutes. Now, this is related to the first and second unit. That is, for a 2-stage network, 9 incoming trunk and 16 outgoing trunk are coming from a switching network having switching size of 3 cross 4, how many such matrices in first stage are required to balance inlet and outlet? Also, we have to calculate the number of cross point for 2-stage network. So, the formula for cross point is 2 into n into m raised to 1 by 2. M is the incoming trunk and n is the outgoing trunk. So, it is total 96 cross point. Now, total 3 switching matrices will be required on per stage if the matrix size is 3 cross 4. 3 cross 4 means at a time in one matrix 3 will be going, and such total 9 incoming trunks are there. So, 3 multiplied by 3, 9 incoming trunks will be there on the per stage. Moving ahead, same question is there listed over here. So, here we are concluding with the numerical sections of telecommunication engineering subject, and We can have the references for this subject in this listed books which are detailed over here. Thank you very much for watching this session, and these numericals will be very helpful to all of you in calculations of telecommunication examples. Thank you for watching this session.